Hi everyone, this is ABCs of Anesthesia, and let's get right to it. So what we're going to talk about today is the three textbooks I found most useful when starting out with anesthesia training. Now, as always, I've got no sponsors, no affiliations, no incentives, so all of this is just completely my opinion. I receive no kickbacks for this. So with that in mind, let's get started. Now, there's obviously so many different textbooks out there that you could probably learn from, and so many other resources. But what I found about anesthesia is that, first of all, from even medical school days, you just didn't do that much anesthesia training. A lot of the time we're doing ward work in general medicine, general surgery, orthopedics, cardiology, and we just didn't get that much time. So when you're first on your anesthetic rotation, it's probably the first time you've actually done much anesthetics, and you don't really get too much time. So I know in our hospital, maybe you'll get a week of anesthesia, and if you want to do an elective, you might get 4 weeks, and that's only some people that get that. So really, it's going to be very unfamiliar to you, and you won't have the same amount of time that the medical school usually gives to other specialties. So first of all, there's lots of information to learn. You need to learn it rapidly. It's really niche information, so very specialized, lots of niche terms, lots of acronyms, lots of skills and knowledge that you probably haven't really thought about before. And so you need to really have the most succinct textbooks that are very focused on what you need to know for anesthesia. Now, just to give you a bit of a start. So in this series, we're going to go through, the best apps, the best journals, the best websites, and the best textbooks. But basically, I think of anesthesia as these range of skills. So firstly, you've got procedural skills, and then pharmacological skills, and then physiology as it relates to clinical anesthesia with, the particular surgery and the patient's pathology. And so those are the three broad areas, and you can divide them up into lots of different things. Now, first of all, procedural skills, the best thing to do is just get in there and with supervision, learn how to do your IV cannulation, vascular access, arterial lines, and airway management, intubations, LMA, bag mask ventilation. And that's stuff that, it's really hard to learn from a textbook or any kind of written resource. You can check out my videos on intubation. I'll probably link up there, as well as I've got a whole playlist on IV cannulation. Again, one of the most important tasks that you'll ever do is IV cannulation. So in this playlist over here, I've pretty much got all the information that, I've gathered over the years. So hopefully that helps you. Now, onto pharmacology and physiology. Now, there's a lot of pharmacology textbooks out there, and again, the aim is that you want something that's brief enough that gives you a really good summary, but also goes into just the amount of detail that you need. And so this is the first resource that I'm going to talk about, which is Pharmacology for Anesthesia and Intensive Care. This is an older edition. It's by Peck Hill and Williams. And I just think, so first of all, this is just a fantastic book that most Australian anaesthetists have probably heard of because they all used it to pass their primary exam. The way this book goes through everything is just incredibly succinct. So, as you can see, this book is only, let's say, about 350 pages long. It's got all the major sections. This is obviously a third edition by Peck Hill and Williams, but there's now newer editions and the range of authors has changed. But it goes through everything from basic principles to core drugs in anesthetic practice. So those first two chapters are absolutely vital because, you'll go through your general anesthetic agents, analgesics, local anesthetics, muscle relaxants, and anticholinesterase. And then it goes into cardiovascular drugs, which again, you use so frequently. Now, the important thing about this is that it doesn't go into a way that most other pharmacology textbooks goes into. There's so many good pharmacology textbooks out there. I think in med school we use Rangdale and Ritter, which was an amazing textbook. And you can also go into some really, really detailed kind of Bibles of pharmacology and anesthesia. One of them is Stolten. Again, very, very good books, but they don't go through it as succinctly as this one does. So this one will go through the way an anesthetist thinks about most of these medications, and then highlight and isolate these very particular niche points about each of them. Now, you can definitely learn about these pharmacological principles in a really brief way in some of my lectures, but I've also just launched a new online course called Medical Student's Guide to Anesthesia, where I go through some of these really basic concepts, and I'll put a link in the notes below as well. So some of the high points of this textbook. Well, first of all, it goes through some of the things that are very niche to anesthesia. For example, if you ever wondered how to run a propofol infusion, this book goes through the pharmacokinetics and the mathematical modeling for that, the way we look at this three-compartment mammalian model, and the way this medication, propofol, is able to redistribute and it's mathematically modeled to do so. So this book goes through that. It also goes through a lot of the other basic concepts, but in an anesthetically relevant way. So some of the highlights from each of the sections, I mean, if you think of volatile agents, you really want to know what anesthetists think is important for their patient care, which is, you know, how do you know if something's going to be fast onset and offset? What are the particular side effects? What's the profile of, you know, cardiovascular depression, vasodilation, venodilation for each of these agents? And again, this will go through that in a really good, concise way. For muscle relaxants, it will not only go through each of the agents, but also go through all the pharmacokinetic principles and pharmacodynamics, as well as some of those interesting things like sucks apnea and Milligan hypothermia, and give you some of the pharmacology about that as well. You know, with local anesthetics, you might want to know about the toxic doses, the CC to CNS ratio. Again, things that I remember never actually reading in my normal pharmacology textbooks, but in this one, absolutely vital. So that's just a bit of a brief summary of this book and a few of the high points. But again, Pharmacology for Anesthesia Intensive Care, fantastic book, and, you know, probably one of the first books I ever bought for anesthesia. Really good to go through. So the next topic is far broader, and this is, how do you really learn the immense amount of physiology and clinical anesthesia that you need to know for anesthesia? So obviously it's such a big topic, and again, the same principle applies. You don't need something with too much detail. For example, you know, people consider Miller's Anesthesiology probably the Bible of anesthesia, and it's a fantastic reference book. It has so much amazing knowledge. I think a lot of us for our final specialty exams will go through the thoracics chapter, we'll go through the airway management chapter, again written by some amazing authors. But the one book that I found really, really useful, aside from some journal articles which I'll talk to about later, was Clinical Anesthesiology by Morgan, McHale and Murray. So this is obviously an older textbook now, but there's, you know, newer editions. And again, I highly recommend this one. The reason I recommend this one is, for a start, it goes into just the right amount of detail without going into unnecessary stuff at a junior level. So, you know, for your specialty exam, you'll definitely have to, you know some of the detail of the papers and the research and all the other clinical aspects. But this goes through a lot of that in just enough bite-sized parcels of information. So just a quick summary, it goes through anesthetic equipment in a nice brief way, and it tells you about the different breathing systems and monitoring. But it also goes through regional anesthesia and pain management, again, in a summarized fashion. And the best thing about it goes through a lot of the concepts of cardiovascular and respiratory physiology, which you absolutely need, and then also anesthesia as it pertains to particular kinds of surgery. For example, you might be having a thoracic list the next day. If you read a bit of that chapter on anesthesia for thoracic surgery, at least it would mean that you would know a lot of those fundamental principles, and that'd be fantastic. Likewise, maybe you've got a neurosurgery case, and instead of reading the Bible anesthesia, or the Bible of neuroanesthesia, you can just read this little chapter and it will go through a lot of that in some, you know, in some decent detail. So that's Morgan McHale, Clinical Anesthesiology. Again, if there's one textbook resource, this is a really good reference type thing where you can just flick to the page before your list, before your case, and do a bit of a read up on that. Now, the final book I want to go through is this one here, which is Anesthesia and Intensive Care, A to Z. So this is by Jentisch, Hirsch and Smith, and it's an encyclopedia of the principle and practice of anesthesia. Now, this is the third edition. Again, there's probably new editions out there, but I found this, especially for my part one and part two exams, an incredibly amazing resource, because it's not just like a dictionary, and it's not quite like an encyclopedia. It's not as detailed as an encyclopedia, but it's not as brief as a dictionary. So while Morgan and McHale goes into a bit more detail, this one is a great reference. So anytime I wasn't sure what a particular term meant, I'd just flick to it and then, you know, get some information. If I was just to flick to any page, maybe you had a patient who had a cardiac arrest and you wanted to learn about defibrillation. It's got this nice section, probably half a page, just on defibrillation and the mechanics of that. Or maybe you want to know about the different laryngoscope blades. So again, it just gives a really nice summary here, which is fantastic, because you really just need a bite-sized bit of information to go into this kind of stuff. And on the next page, again, you know, it's really hard to be able to find really good resources for airway anatomy, but again, this book just has a really great summary of each of these principles. Look, so that's probably all I wanted to go into. If you have any questions or comments, please leave it below. But also, if you have any other suggestions for textbook that you found more useful or just really useful for your anesthetic training, please leave it in the comments below. And I'd love to hear about it. I'd love to find out where the best points of knowledge are, where I can, you know, refer people to, where I can learn for myself. So please leave it in the comments if you found any other resources or textbooks that were really fantastic. So as always, if you enjoyed this video, please share with anyone who might be interested in this topic. For the next series of videos, we're going to go through the best apps, the best websites, and the best journal articles, just as a bit of a how to get good resource for anesthesia. And we'll see you next time. Thanks very much for watching.